Charlie Gard's parents were told that their son had irreversible brain damage after he suffered seizures before Christmas, but they did not believe it. They maintained that an MRI scan in January showed the brain was normal. That has been the crux of the difference between parents and the hospital. Connie Yates and Chris Gard, bolstered by the opinions of doctors in other countries who had not seen their child, believed treatment was possible. Their hopes came to an end at the weekend. After Michio Hirano, the U.S. neurologist who had offered an experimental drug therapy, finally accepted an invitation that had been open since Christmas to come to London and see Charlie. He was expected to explain in court the new evidence that he said suggested nucleoside bypass therapy, NBT, could help Charlie. Guardian morning briefing. Sign up and start the day one step ahead. Read more. Instead, the parents' lawyer stood up to say they were ending the legal fight. He stated that Charlie's muscle wastage meant it was too late to treat him. But Hirano, who had not seen Charlie, the scans are the medical notes when he made a first appearance in court on the 13th of July, had been shown new imaging of the brain damage that Great Ormond Street Hospital, GOSH, had always said was irreversible. Charlie has a very rare mitochondrial disease caused by a genetic defect inherited from his parents. The diagnosis is infantile onset encephalomyopathic mitochondrial DNA depletion syndrome, referred to generally as MDDS. It causes the body's cells and end organs to shut down. Charlie cannot move or breathe by himself, is deaf and has epilepsy. The outlook, GOSH always said, was bleak. Even so, GOSH contacted international experts including Hirano, to find out whether NBT was an option. The seizures caused brain damage that made the GOSH doctors, also experts in this field, convinced that Charlie could not recover. They also believe he is in pain. Even now, Charlie shows physical responses to stressor that some of those treating him interpret as pain, and when two international experts assessed him last week, they believed that they elicited a pain response, said the GOSH statement on Monday. But Yates and Gard, convinced he could recover, rejected the advice that the kindest thing would be to switch off the machines keeping him alive, so the hospital went to court and got the order they requested. They continue to believe Charlie could have recovered if he had been given NBT in the early part of this year. GOSH, however, thinks they were misled. The new evidence was not helpful. Devastatingly, the information obtained since the 13th of July gives no cause for optimism. Rather, it confirms that whilst NBT may well assist others in the future, it cannot and could not have assisted Charlie, said the hospital. Timeline. Charlie Gard and his parents' legal battle to save him. It would give thought to what it could learn from the bruising court case, it said. It is hoped that those who, like the professor, have provided the opinions that have so sustained Charlie's parents, their hopes and thus this protracted litigation with its many consequences, will also find much upon which to reflect. The life support machines that have been keeping Charlie alive will not be switched off instantly. The hospital will allow his parents to spend more time with their baby before they have to let him go. All of GOSH's thoughts go with Charlie and his mother and father. The hospital wishes each of them peace in their hearts at the end of this day and each day to come.